So let's talk about subtracting integers, and in particular, let's talk about subtracting a negative from a positive, a negative integer from a positive integer, which means we'll start with a positive and then subtract a negative value. So our example is going to be 5 minus negative 3. We had 5 and we were subtracting a negative 3. And to kind of help understand this, let's think about it this way. If we had just the equation 5 minus 3, it wasn't minus a negative 3, but it was 5 minus 3. A lot of y'all know this equals 2. And if I modeled this on a number line, I'd be starting at 5 right here where the blue dot is. And I'd take away 3, which means I'd move 1, 2, 3 places on the number line this direction. Because I'm moving negatively, I'm subtracting that value from what I have. And so I would get positive 2. Okay, well, let's go back and look at this one up top then. 5 minus a negative 3. What happens when we subtract a negative value? On this example, I subtracted a positive value. I subtracted that value away. But now I'm subtracting a negative value. So that really changes what we end up doing. So I'll go back here and erase this number line out. And we're starting at 5. 5 is our starting point. But when we subtract a negative, what actually happens, instead of moving to the left, because we have kind of this double negative situation here, you're actually going to move to the right, whatever the value is of that integer. So in this case, it's subtracting a negative 3. So I'm actually going to move 1, 2, 3 spaces to the right, and that would get me to land right there on positive 8. So a little hard to understand sometimes, but when you look that you have a subtraction sign and a negative, you're subtracting a negative, actually means it's kind of a double negative. And if you're familiar with language arts, if you're familiar with the double negative in grammar, a double negative means you say a negative thing twice and it cancels it out and makes a positive. Something like, I'm not going to the football game. Sounds very confusing to say that, and it's not really grammatically correct. But if you said, I'm not going to the football game, the truth is, if you think about that, someone really is probably going to go to the football game. If they took out one of these nots right here, I'm not going to the football game means I'm not going. If we take that all away, I'm not going to go. Those two negatives work against each other, and it makes a positive. So when we go back over here, the way I try to remember this is when you have a number, a positive number, and you subtract a negative, what we're going to remember to do is take this negative sign, carry it over, you turn it sideways, and it makes a positive out of it. So it really turns this into 5 plus 3, which equals 8, which is exactly where we get right over there. So let's try another example right over here. What if we start with 7 and we subtract a negative, let's subtract a negative 8. See what we get on this. So again, I'm starting at 7, but this is that whole double negative thing. I'm subtracting, but I'm subtracting a negative value. So I'm going to carry my little negative sign over. I'm going to turn it sideways. And if I rewrite this, it turns it into a plus sign, like a little dotted plus sign that goes across. I didn't do that real nice. Little dotted plus sign that goes across. And 7 plus now 8. And that means I would move 8 spaces to the right, which 7 and 8 gets me 15, which would get me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then one more would put me right at 15. So when you subtract a negative, the thing to remember is carry that minus sign, that negative sign, excuse me, over to the minus, turn it into a positive, and add that up.